Today we're going to be reviewing the Quintero Panetela cigar, an affordable Cuban stick. This is a short filler, hand rolled cigar. Coming in at 5 inches with a 36 ring gauge, and I'm looking at an online price here of $8.99. So it's a very nicely affordable, well presented cigar, which I'm looking forward to enjoying. After my last review, the Montecristo number 4, I'll put the link up here if you haven't seen that video, wasn't all that impressed, and it went crazy in the comments section with people saying that they loved the cigar, having people saying that they didn't like the cigar, and there was people in the middle. They were talking about inconsistencies. So I'm looking forward to getting tucked into this Quintero to see how this compares to the Montecristo number 4. As this cigar is a cheaper stick than the number 4, if this performs better, then I know what I'm going to be recommending to you guys towards the end of this video. Dry draw, very snug, not plugged. It just looks and feels very well packed. Let's get this thing toasted and let's go for a first draw. Ah. It's a nice one. Some people will say to you, you can't judge a cigar within the first few draws. I definitely, without a doubt, disagree with that comment. Obviously, the cigar might change and develop negatively throughout, but in terms of its flavors, right at the very start, I'm liking this already. There's a nice hazelnut flavor to it with those typical Cuban tobacco flavors, wood, cedar, and there's a light sweetness there as well. Hopefully I'll be able to pick out exactly what that sweetness is later on down the stick. There's a light smoke output, very nice sweet room note. There's some espresso on the retrohale, which is really nice. I have to say, I'm impressed. Seems like quite a complex stick for a budget Cuban cigar. Lots of different flavors, and the flavors that are there are very nice, working well together. I'm quite excited about this cigar now, because before starting this video, I wasn't overly enthused about trying this cigar. I'm just like, budget Cuban, not really very inspired to try that. But that's the whole idea in these videos, to try everything from the cheapest to the most expensive, both in New World and Cuban cigars, to discover little gems like this. So, as you can see, I'm around the halfway mark now, and happy to say this is smoking really well. And whilst I was sat back enjoying this stick, I looked in the humidor and I was looking at what I have lined up for the channel. And we've actually got a couple of these in the humidor, and myself and Hazel are going to review these on a video next week. So keep your eye out for that. I'd be interested to see how it compares with this Quintero. Bearing in mind, this Quintero is around £8, £9 to £10, depending on where you're shopping. And this Cohiba Panetela cigar is £13. £13 is absolutely tiny. It's weeny, and it's 13 quid. If this doesn't live up to its price tag, I am going to be very disappointed. So I'm glad Hazel's going to be here. We're going to have two posing views and opinions on this Cohiba cigar, so keep your eye out for that. If you're watching this video at some point in the future when the video is ready, I'll put the link here. If I forget, spam me with comments and remind me. Thanks. Back to this Quintero cigar. Smoking really well. Had to relight it because, as always, go and do a few bits and pieces, make a drink, go to the toilet. Oh, that was chaos. Flavors from this cigar, I'm getting a lot of oak, which is nice. It's like a solid oaky flavor, which is really pleasurable, along with a little bit of coffee, and there is some sweet caramel flavors in there as well. So some really nice combinations in there for a budget Cuban cigar. Pretty much a razor sharp burn, which is excellent, and overall it's just a very good performing cigar. Making my way down to the band, and overall this is a faultless budget Cuban cigar. absolutely no complaints about it. It's burnt well, burnt consistently, and surprisingly, this thing has lasted me quite a while. I'm at around the 30 minute mark now online. It says around 20 minutes, so obviously this depends on smoking style. Now the question is, who would I recommend this cigar to? This is the sort of thing that will be great for beginners because of the price bracket. Also for more advanced cigar smokers, this thing is cheap, it's convenient, and it provides a really good overall experience. This is one of those cigars that you can smoke daily if that's the sort of thing that you're looking for. If not, it's one of those useful cigars to have in your humidor for those occasional spontaneous smokes. I'm gonna continue smoking this down. I'm gonna enjoy it right down to the nub. But for now, I'm gonna close this video out. If you did enjoy this video, please don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.